Sweeney Todd is a movie based on the 1970 musical by the same name. I'm going to be talking about the 2007 movie, but not the original play. John Solo has good videos about the musical, which you should definitely watch if you're interested in that. The movie is about Benjamin Barker, a prisoner returning to London. He used to be a barber, and he decided to become a barber again. But instead, he kills his customers and gives the meat to Mrs. Lovett, the woman he works with. Mrs. Lovett makes pies from the human meat. Benjamin Barker, now called Sweeney Todd, wants to take revenge on Judge Turpin, who had taken his daughter Johanna. Ms. Lovett has plans on marrying Todd and moving near the sea, but Todd doesn't care about that as he simply wants to kill Judge Turpin. You understand Sweeney Todd's motivations and anger, but his revenge and murder isn't justified as you realize how evil Benjamin Barker is. Lovett is a morally better character, but she's definitely flawed as she makes the humans into meat and also lies to Todd, which we will get to later. And Judge Turpin, while evil, isn't much eviler than Todd himself. And in the movie, when Judge Turpin is finally murdered by Sweeney Todd, we feel no satisfaction. We don't feel happy about Benjamin succeeding, because this was an evil revenge plan. There's some excitement when Sweeney Todd yells his original name.
Benjamin Barker!
But it's instantly followed by horrifying serial killer music similar to the Michael Myers theme. This isn't a scene like Iron Man snapping his fingers. This is a gruesome scene of the villain killing the other villain. And after this, it's not much better as he goes downstairs to where Lovett is, to see all the dead bodies. And he finds his wife. His wife from years ago, who he thought died from poison years ago. But she actually died a few minutes ago by the knives of Todd. Ms. Lovett had lied to him by saying that she died from the poison. Sweeney Todd is infuriated. He gets up, and Lovett, thinking she's forgiven, dances with him.
Only alive, my dear. So let's keep living it. Just keep living it. Really living it.
But Todd throws her into the burning fires where she burns and quickly dies painfully. At the end, just before the credits, Benjamin Barker is killed by the boy they adopted. What I think is so great about the movie is how you don't know who to root for. You either root for a murderer, a liar, or a kidnapper. You feel sympathy for them. You want them to succeed, but not how they are. It's truly a great story about the rights and wrongs of life.